I welcome you for the second section of political science class. As in the previous class, we have discussed about the constitution in the general way. What is a constitution? As I have explained to you, constitution is nothing but rules and regulation which is necessary. And we have discussed about the Indian constitution, how we have adopted, how the leaders, freedom fighters, the leaders have taken the contribution in order to adopt our constitution, and what type of government we have adopted. We have discussed at the central level and at the state level also. In this class today, we are going to discuss about the syllabus. What first we'll discuss about the syllabus, what we are going to deal in this academic year. The first chapter is nothing but it is an introduction of political science. Introduction of political science means what is a political science, what is the meaning of political science we are going to discuss, and the different definition which has been given by the political writers, all we are going to discuss in the first chapter. And the second chapter we are going to discuss about the state. That means what is a state is nothing but it is a political institution. How the political institution, what is the meaning of the state, definition of the states are there, how the state has came into the existence, everything, and what are the essential elements of the state, we are going to discuss in this second chapter. The third chapter we are going to discuss about the nation state and nationalism. Nation state, how the states got the recognition as a nation states, and what is the meaning or the importance of nation state, what is nationalism, all these concepts we are going to discuss in the third chapter. Fourth chapter we are going to discuss about political concepts. Political concepts like law, liberty, equality, fraternity, and justice, power. These concepts all need to be known as political concepts. And these political concepts we are going to discuss individually. For example, like law. What is a law? Law is nothing but it is a concept, the set of rules and regulation. These all concepts we are going to discuss in the fourth chapter, which comes under the political concept. Fifth chapter, we are going to discuss about the important political ideologies. That means how the features, how the liberalism has came into the existence. What are the basic features of socialism? What are the ideologies has been taken into consideration? As we know, so the ideology of Gandhism. What are the basic features are there? All these ideologies we are going to discuss in the fifth chapter, important political ideologies. In the sixth chapter, we are going to discuss about the rights and duties. That means what is right, what are duties, and the definition of rights are there, and the duties are there, and the different types of rights and different types of duties. All in the detail we are going to discuss in the sixth chapter. That is nothing but rights and duties. Coming to the seventh chapter, we are going to discuss about the citizenship. That means what is the citizenship means? Introduction and the concept of citizenship. How we can acquire the citizenship. What are the qualities of good citizenship? All we are going to discuss in this seventh chapter. Eighth chapter, we are going to discuss about democracy. That means what is a democracy means? And what are the features are there? What are the essential elements of the democracy? Generally, we are going to discuss in this eighth chapter. In the ninth chapter, we are going to discuss about secularism. That means what is a secularism? Is nothing but feeling oneness. And now what is the meaning is there? Important features are there of secularism? We are going to discuss in the ninth chapter. Coming to the tenth chapter, we are going to discuss about the constitution. That means what is a constitution? That nothing but it is a rules and regulation. We are going to discuss about the meaning and the definition of constitution, types of constitutions are there, and the classification of constitution we are going to discuss in this 10th chapter. 11th chapter, we are going to discuss about the organs of the government. That means the concept of government. What is the government means? Government is nothing but it is an agency through which the will of a nation can be expressed. In this, we are going to discuss about the theory of separation of power. That means how we are dividing the government at the center and at the state. That means all the countries are not adopted parliamentary form of government, and we are going to discuss about the presidential form of government and the organs of the government. How many organs are there? Already have discussed. We have discussed in the previous class. There are three organs of the government. That is legislature, executive, and judiciary. What legislature means? there asks what the executive means, it implements the laws. What is the judiciary means? Judiciary is nothing but it implements the laws. This we are going to discuss in this 11th chapter, organs of the government. The next 12th chapter, we are going to discuss about the forms of government. Organs are different, forms are different. Forms of government means we are going to discuss about the classification of government, modern classification and the traditional classification. That means monarchy, it comes under the monarchy type of government, it comes under the traditional. And modern classification, dividing the government between federal and unitary. That means at the central and at the state level. This all comes under the forms of government. That means in this academic year, we are going to discuss, we are having the 12 chapters are there. And these 12 chapters are interlinked with one concept, one chapter to the another chapter. First, we are going to discuss about the political science. The second chapter, we are going to discuss about the state. The third chapter, we are going to discuss about the nation state and nationalism. The fourth chapter, we are going to discuss about political concepts. Then fifth chapter, we are going to discuss about the important political ideology. The sixth chapter, we are going to discuss about the rights and duties. Seventh chapter, we are going to discuss about citizenship. Eighth chapter, we are going to discuss about the democracy. The ninth, secularism. Tenth chapter, constitution. 11th chapter, organs of government. And 12th chapter, last chapter, is the forms of government. These are the syllabus what we are going to discuss in this academic year. We will start a new first chapter with the introduction of political science. That means in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the meaning, nature and the scope of political science with the introduction about. What interaction about what is a political science? First, we have to analyze ourselves. What is a political science actually means? That before knowing of this political science, first we have to go with the previous classes what you have discussed. How the evolution of human beings has came into the existence. As early man has came. And how this evolution of human beings, how they have been associated with the societies for the survival. For the better life also. Why they need the better life? Because they need to satisfy the needs of the people. If they want to satisfy the needs of the people, they have to establish and they should be organized into one unit. That means they should be in the society. If the society comes into the existence, the leading group of people call themselves, what they will call themselves, the needs, the competition should be there, understanding should be there between them. They should not have arise any conflict. If any conflict arises, how to solve this conflict also? These all political authorities and the concepts comes under the organized way of life. That means we are living an organized life. Why? Because as the human beings, as the modernity has came into the existence, we need, apart from the needs of the human beings, we need the comparison, the compromise and the resolutions also should be needed for us for in order to overcome with the conflict whatever arises into the society. For that purpose, what we are doing, we are organizing ourselves. How we are organizing? We are arranging ourselves into the state. That is nothing but it is known as political institution. Why? Because we are having the obligations of the We are exercising our rights in order to for the development of human beings as well as the society also. If you are studying in the detail about the organized society, that is nothing but it is known as political science. Understood, girls? That means what is a political science? It is nothing but a study of such an organized society. It is nothing but it is known as political science. Political science is nothing but the science which deals with the politics. What type of politics we are dealing here? How we are organizing ourselves? How we are organizing? We are formed into the society. The group of societies comes into the recognition as a state. And this state needs, apart from the satisfying the needs, basic needs of human life, we need the understanding should be there, cooperation should be there, and the resolution. We have to pass the resolution also if any conflict arises. How to solve these conflicts also? That means we have organized into one unit. What is the one unit there? That is a unit is nothing but it is an organized society. That organized society is nothing but it is known as state. If we are learning, that means how the study of such organized society is nothing but it is known as political science. In this chapter, in the detail, we are going to discuss about what is a political science. That means, what is a political science? It is nothing but, it is the study of a political science, nothing but the science which deals with the politics. How the society has came into the existence. What is the process? Actually, the process of competition. What is the conflict will be there? How the cooperation should be there between the one human being to the another human being? And what are the responsibilities are there between the human beings and the society? All this comes under the political science. Next question will be that, what is political science? Actually, what is the meaning of political science? That when we are studying about the political science, the first term, what we are referring that, what is studied? That means what we have studied in the previous. What we have studied, how the evolution of human beings has came into the existence. That means what we are doing, we are describing the two terms. And that means we are studying about the political science into two terms. What the first is, the first term refers to what is studied, and second term refers to how it is studied by us. That means how we are studying about the state, how the evolution of the state has come into existence. What is the historical background in the back of the state? It comes under the how it is studied. That means this, in the short, we can say that the political science is nothing but it is a scope of subject. That is a scope of subject. Where we are, why, what we are doing here, we are referring to that. What we are referring to that, how the states has came into the existence. That means we are discussing about the political science and the political concepts. That comes under the political science. Politics is nothing but, it has been derived from the Greek word polis, which means a city state. That means the city state, this city state was known as a sovereign state. What is a sovereign state means? Sovereign state is nothing but where the supreme power will be in the hands of the state itself. That means we, the people of India, we are saying that we are the people of, we are the citizen of India. That means we are having all the rights to change the government. I mean, we are having the right to criticize the government also. Why? Because the sovereign power will be vested in the hands of the people only. That means this cities, this states will be known as a sovereign state. Science is nothing but it is to know. What we are doing here, we are studying about. What we are studying about, how this political science, that means how the sovereignty has been given to the state, and how this science, how we are studying about, how we are knowing about this political concept, they got in the important. Political science is nothing but it is a study of state and government. That means we are reading a relationship between state and government. State means what? We are learning about the individual, the human beings, and what are the responsibilities of the human beings towards the family, towards the state. And how the government, what is the government means, is nothing but, a government is nothing but it is an agency of a state where the will of a nation can be expressed. That means without the government, the state cannot organize itself. Rules and regulations cannot be formed. This study is nothing but it is known as political science. That means we are understanding about the state, what are the principles and ideas underlying its organization and the activities, how the organizations has came into the existence, what activities which has been involved in the formation of the state. It comes under the study of political science. And when we are talking about the government, we are learning about the body of politics, that means association of the people in the political community, how they are participating, how they are involved, and what is the relation of men and the group, and how, what is the relation between the men and the groups to the state. That means from one state to the another state. As we know, our country India, we are 129 states are there, and how we are interlinked between one state to the another state. As we know, isolated state cannot be developed. This relationship comes under the study of political science. Understood, girls? What is a political science? Political science is nothing but the study of state and government. Political science is nothing but it is a study of a state, and it is a study of state and government. It is showing the relationship between the state and government. Politics is nothing but a study of political science. Then next, coming to the meaning of political science. When we are learning, knowing about the political science, is nothing but it is a systematic study of state and government, we are saying. That means it's a systematic study of state. How the evolution of state has came into the existence, what are the essential elements are there, what is the relation between the state and government. That means political science is nothing but it is a social science. How the people have associated themselves, how we have associated to this civil society, what the practices we are practicing, what are the theories of the politics comes, what we are analyzing ourselves, the political system, what the type of political system it is there, how we are studying about the political behavior. Political system means, for example, like as in the previous class I have explained to you about the federal type of government, how we have adopted the parliament at the center and the state legislative assemblies at the state level. Like this, we are dividing the powers between the center and the state government. That means we are learning and analyzing ourselves what political systems have been practiced and how this study of political behavior it is there. What type of political parties comes into the existence? Which political parties gives us more support? Like this, this all it comes under the political science. That means in the simple way we can say that political science is nothing but it is a systematic study of state and government. That means we are learning about, we are studying about the state and government. We are learning about the relation between the state and government. State, it is a political institution, whereas the government, it is an agency through which the will of a nation can be expressed. That means whatever the type of development the state needs, it can be expressed only by the government. That is nothing but it is known as political science. Political science, it is having the different dimensions are there. That means political science, it is also known as social science. Political science, it is a it involves all the political activities. It shows the relation between the government, international relationship and the public administration. That means it educate, political science, it educate us to know about what is the social science. What is the social science means? Social science is nothing but it is a branch of science which where we are studying about the society. That means how the individuals in this society, they have come into the an organized society. That is nothing but it is known as science of society. The science of society, if we are learning about that, that becomes a social science for us. That means it has been came into existence from the 19th century. From the 19th century, in order to have the comparison and in order to know about what type of political science, what type of welfare and how the social history has been changed from one century to the another century, it comes under the social science. That means the social science, that the political science, it is also known as social science. Why we are saying it as a social science? Because the social science is nothing but it is a branch of science where we are devoting, where we are studying about the societies. That means what is the relation between the individuals within those society. That means what is the relation between the one individual to the another individual into the society, and how the original, that means how the sociology, that means how the societies has came to the existence, and that comes under the science of society. And this is was established in the year 19th century and it was known as sociology. That means the social science is also known as sociology. That means what we are knowing here, we are knowing about the economics, we are learning about human geography, how the human geography differs from one state to the another state, what is the management science is there, and like this, all this concept comes under the social science. That means the social science, political science is also known as social science. The next, it is a government. That means political science is nothing but it studies about the state and government. That means why we need the government in order to put a systematic code of conduct. Why we need this systematic code of conduct? In order to have, in order to utilize the rights and whatever the obligations have to be paid by the individual, it should be done. That means the government is nothing but it is an agency through which the will of a nation can be expressed. That means it is a system. Government is nothing but it is a system. How we are governing ourselves. Without the government, we cannot govern ourselves. Why we cannot govern ourselves? Because the will of a nation or what type of development it is needed for the development of the state cannot be expressed by the government. For that purpose, the government, it is nothing but it is a system for us in order to govern ourselves. That means in order to a system of social control under which what we are doing, we are utilizing our rights and the rights, how we have to enforce them. And apart from that, in a particular group or in the how we are establishing our rights, all will be studied in under this government. That means government is, it is also a part of a political science. Government is nothing but it is an agency. Why we are saying it is an agency? In a simple way we can say it as a government is nothing but it is a system for us. Why we need this system? In order to govern ourselves. Why we are governing ourselves? In order to control all the social activities. If any conflict arises between one society to the another society, or one individual to the another individual into the society, can be controlled only by the government. For that purpose, the government, it is also a part of political science. Next, coming to the public administration. What is the public administration? Public administration is nothing but implementation of governmental policies. What type of policies? It may be a developmental policies where the civil servants, they will be working as a public services, and they will have the authority into the field to inquire what type of scopes are they. The, for example, like fundamental goals will be there. If any advanced management and the policies has to be formulated, it can be done by the public administration only. That means how to implement all the rules and regulations and translation of politics into the reality, that how the citizens can see into the daily life and how the citizens can participate into the political activities. That means getting the making the aware of the citizens to know about the government decision making, and if this awareness will be given to the people, they can analyze what policies have been implemented into the society by themselves only. And if this will be get into the existence, then the human beings can participate into the governmental activities. Participation is must. If there no participation will be there, then there is not meaning of a government. This comes under the public administration only. Public administration is nothing but implementation of government policies. Government policies, and this implementation of governmental policies, it will be for the development of the state. That means here the civil servants, they will be working as a one unit. They are prepared and they are inquiring into what type of scopes, what type of fundamental goals have to be achieved, and how the government can function better. This all it will be managed by the public public administration, by the public programs. And these programs, it enables us to know the reality, that the citizens every day, what the type of policies have been implemented. If these implementations, what decision is taken by the government, it can be studied by the citizens. If the citizens will study about the government decision making, that's the sense they can analyze themselves, the what type of policies have been implemented, and how they can input, what is input and what are the output has come into the existence into the government. It can be implemented only, can be implemented by the public administration. That means a public administration also, it comes under the political science. The next, it is the international relationship. That means what is international relation? It is nothing but international relation is the first. The international studies, that is the global studies between the one country to the another country. Why we need this? Because in order to increase the economy of one country to the another country, and to know about the recognition, if we need a recognition of one country to the another country, as international relations should be the good. In that sense, we have to be interconnected. If we are interconnected, that means we have to know about what the type of economy is there, and how the laws has been imposed in the global level, and what type of interdisciplinary academic has to be come into the global studies by one country to the another country. Why we need this one? Because international recognition is compulsory. If international recognition will be there, then the developmental process can be come into across. For that purpose, this also international recognition or the international relation, it also comes under the study of political science. What is international relation? Knowing about the international relation between one country to the another country. What we are studying here? We are studying about the global studies. What global studies we are studying here? What type of global efforts are there between one country to the another country? Where we are saying that India, it is a developing country, whereas America, it is a developed country. That means what we are doing here? with a developed strategy. We are adopting the developed strategy is adopted by the developing nation in order to develop the nation. Like this, this relationship should be there. This also study comes under the political science. The last it is economics. Economics is also it comes under the study of political science. Why we need and this economics it is also known as social science. That means it is studying about what type of production it is there, distribution and the consumption of goods and services. Why? Because without the economy, the nation state cannot be developed. Without the economy, all these political concepts and all this political administration cannot be run into the country. For that purpose, economy also, economics also plays an important role in the study of political science. That means economics, it is nothing but it is also known as social science. Why we are saying it as a social science? Because it studies about the production. What type of production, how the distribution and the consumption of goods and services are there, and how we are dealing with the price, how the quantity has to be increased, what are the quality life should be given to the one state to the another state. For that purpose, we are saying that economics also comes under the study of political science. That means what we have discussed here, my girls, we have discussed about what is political science. In the general introduction, we have discussed about what is a political science. Political science is nothing but it is the study of a city state. And what is a city state means? A city state means nothing but it is a sovereign state. Why we are saying it as a sovereign state? Because the supreme power will be vested in the hands of the state itself. And this is science. Science is nothing but it is nothing but it is to know, to study about. What we are studying here, we are studying about the difference, the relation between the state and the government. That comes under the study of political science. Political science is nothing but we are understanding about the state and the government. What principles are there, what organization activities are there, and how this politics has been associated with the people, and how we are studying about the relation of the men in the group and the men into the group of one state to the another state. This all comes under the study of political science. Apart from that, we have discussed about the political science is nothing but it is a systematic study of state. And the political science, it is also known as social science, where we have discussed about the different dimensions. That means political science is also known as social sciences, where the political activities are there, government, international relation and the public administration. Economics also comes under the political science, where we have discussed about the social science. Social science is nothing but it is a branch of science, where we are studying about the society. Why we need this study of society? Because in order to know about what type of changes have been done from the one society to the another society. And already we have discussed about the government also. What is a government means? It is nothing but a system, or this system it is needed in order to govern ourselves. And government is also known as it is an agency through which the will of a nation can be expressed. How we can express our will in accordance to the right, how to make our rights, how we have to enforce them, and how it in a particular, which is vested in the particular society, thus comes under the study of government. Then we have discussed about the public administration is nothing but implementation of governmental policies. International relationship comes under the study of political science, and the economics also comes under the study of political science, and the economics is known as the social science. That means today we have discussed in the general way what is political science. What is a political science? It is nothing but study of state and government. Why we are saying it as a study of state and government? Because we are studying about an organized, that is a political life. Thus comes under the study of political science. Why we are saying that political science, it refers to the systematic code of systematic way of studying of the politics, which differs from one nation, one country to the another country. These all concepts comes under the study of political science. That means the two terms we have discussed in this class, about the first term is about what is studied, and second it is about how it is studied. That means what we have studied in the previous and how we have studied, it comes under the next class. And in the next class, we are going to discuss about the origin, that is the mean nature and the meaning of political science. Different definitions are there, how these definitions has came into the existence, and how the political writers, they have been given the different views of the different views on the political science, the scope of political science. Thank you, students.